It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week, we're joined by PODkins to discuss the latest gaming news and to talk about just how bad Monday Night Raw has been lately. Really bad.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 47 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny. With me, as always, is Finn Steele.
Hello.
And joining us this week, our special guest, back again.
Woo.
Friend of the show, Steve, aka PODkins.
Hello.
Hello.
How's everyone doing?
I'm good.
Finn, you've got glasses.
I do. I have glasses now.
You completed the nerd set.
I have. I'm now a complete 100% nerd. Confirmed.
I've put it on Twitter, so now it's definitely confirmed.
Oh, yeah. Cheers to that.
You're welcome.
I quite like them, actually. I think they quite suit me quite well.
Yeah, but I agree.
Thank you.
The most important thing is here that you need them.
Yes, I do, actually. I don't know. Yeah. It's mostly for like computers and stuff and in front of the TV, so
again,
all the time.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Exactly. All the time. Yeah.
Yeah. But other than that, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. How about you?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you.
How are you, Steve?
I'm alright.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Cool. Not bad.
Pretty good.
Not
bad. Look at us all in good health.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
2017 so far is a winner.
Makes a change, yeah.
It's a real winner.
Thank goodness.
So it was your birthday this past week.
It was.
How was it?
Yes, very good, thank you, yeah.
29 years old.
I am, an old man now.
You are.
Yeah.
Next year, you're an old man.
Yeah, getting close to big 3-0.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're past it, and we still act like idiots, so
that's
it's
all right,
fine.
Yeah, cool, okay. I've got nothing to worry about.
No, you've got nothing to worry about.
I act like an idiot.
Yeah, for sure.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's right.
I was looking at people like Ricky Gervais, who's like in his 50s, and he's an absolute pillar. He's
hilarious. That's a good point.
But he's funny with it, so he's still really immature, so...
Cool.
Yeah, you've got at least another 20, 30 years of this yet.
Thank goodness.
This.
This nonsense, yeah.
Finn, it was your 50th birthday this past week.
Welcome to episode 5000.
Yeah.
Did you treat yourself to some VR porn for your birthday?
Not for my birthday, no.
Have you tried it?
So what?
Have you tried it?
I have tried it, yes.
Yes!
Have you
tried it?
Yes. Have you?
No. I wanted you to try it.
Of course you did.
Okay. Tell me how it was.
Garbage.
Was it garbage?
Absolute garbage.
Okay, so...
The video quality on the on PS4 VR isn't good enough.
Is it? It doesn't give me the sex experience that I want.
Exactly. It's like, I don't know. First of all, it's way too much effort. I don't know how much time you'd spend, you know, in your personal time doing that stuff. I didn't spend that long. I was trying to word it. I don't know. But yeah, it's crap. Don't bother.
Right. Okay. Yeah. So did it not give you the sensation of like actually being in the room or?
No. I thought 2 seconds. I thought, yeah, it's crap.
Well, that was quick.
Turn it off. Yeah. Why so long last? I don't know about you.
2 seconds?
Yeah. Why is that not long enough?
So it wasn't good.
Explains why I'm single. yeah, it's crap. Yeah.
Right. Okay. So not recommended to people?
No. Stick with regular porn.
Right, very well. So, Pornhub is, you know, free on your phones, guys, come on.
Yeah, I mean, you think doing faff around with bloody USB sticks and PS4 VR. So
it does seem a lot of effort for
it's way too
five
much effort.
Minutes, maybe less.
Five minutes?
Oh, wow, Pins.
Yeah, sorry, I'm overselling myself.
4 minutes, jeez.
For not many minutes of fun time Frankie time.
Yeah, it's, yeah, not worth it.
Okay, good review.
Yes, 1 star.
This is the Sonny and Finn Show, and we are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts every single Friday across podcast services everywhere.
Yes.
And we are now part of Daydreamer Gaming.
Yes.
We are now part of Daydreamer Gaming, and we've been doing lots of fun stuff.
Yep.
And yeah, it's been a good first week, I think.
Yeah, pretty good.
We were only a couple of days in last week. Stevie, did your first ever stream?
I did.
How did you find it? Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, I did, yeah. To be honest, it's no different to what I tend to do when I play FIFA anyway. I'm always sort of commenting and swearing at the ref and saying, what the fuck are you doing? What sort of shot was that? What, that was crap. So, yeah. But instead you're just doing it into a microphone. Sometimes you're a bit more careful about what you say.
Yeah.
So,
maybe, yeah.
But no, I enjoyed it. I was a little bit, I'll be honest, a little bit nervous, like doing it.
I think that's a normal thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Because Dippy texted me He said he was nervous about doing his.
Yeah.
We didn't get to do his in the end because Twitch was fucking around on Xbox.
Yeah.
We'll get to do it at some point. We'll get inspired. Yeah. But he said he was nervous too.
So I did that first stream that just went completely wrong.
Mm.
And set it all up and did all that. And then like Claire came, the wife came home and was like, what, do I really want to talk into a headset while she's in the room? She was totally cool with it. Mm. And I just kind of went, just froze. And then just ended up playing FIFA badly for about 4 minutes. And then I was like, I'll delete that. It was awful. So I tried it again the following night, no problems. And now I just want to keep doing it. Yeah. So
see, I think once you get the bug, you're like, right now, what can I do next? And how can I improve it? And well, that's what, I mean, when we first started it, like, I hadn't done any streaming before. Finn had made videos and stuff. And I was nervous too. I didn't know what to do and... or how to act or what to say and stuff like that. But I think it's the more you do it, the more natural it becomes. And you just now, like when I stream, it's just, oh, right, this is it. And here we are. Mm. And you just talk your way through it. But I think it is one of the things you just grow into.
Yeah, for sure. Like, even when I was doing my Mario Maker video today, we got quite a few more views than we do to get. And then once I saw the views and like being like positive and good, I was like, start to freeze up a little bit as well. It's like, oh god, people are watching. What do I say?
Well, yeah, that's it. I think you feel like you have to perform better.
So I'm trying to be like funny and say like react to what's happening. It's like, and then just sit there and like silence for like a couple minutes.
I think the best thing to do is to not let that bother you.
Yeah,
like, not let the amount of people watching take over.
Yeah, eventually I'll go over it and it's like, oh, okay, that's myself and carry on.
What's good is that we do have regular viewers, and then when they are in the comments, it's sort of balances it out a bit, so you just be how you are when they're in there and they're talking to you and stuff. So but that's good. I'm glad that you're doing it. This is what I wanted to do. I wanted it to give people a platform to who haven't done it before to do it. It's like with yourself, and now you want to do more stuff, and with Dippy, and I think even with the other guys, even with Viz, he's streaming way more than like he would usually and stuff like that. And we've still got people on the team who haven't done any stuff yet, and they plan to, and it's just, you know, they got to deal with stuff in real life first before they go and do it. And we had the Twitch problems with Dippy, and all them things all smooth themselves out, and it'll be good. And I think we're onto something.
Yeah, I think so.
We do.
Yeah.
So on the subject of gaming, we'll start with you, Steve. What have you been playing?
So I've been playing FIFA 17, which is what I've been streaming mainly. Well, it's the only thing I've been streaming. So getting back into that. And I've been playing Batman Telltale. I've been playing through that. So I bought that when it was in the sale. Finished episode 4, so I've just got the final.
Oh, you've got the last one to do.
So I've got the last one to do. And then I plan to play through it again. I'll stream it or do a video or whatever. But I'll go through the story as Batman being a badass.
Ah, okay.
So breaking bones and killing people and
nice.
All that sounds good.
Yeah.
What so I love about...
I've been a bit sort of middle... Sorry, I've been a bit sort of like... Try to be a bit of a nice-ish Batman, sort of a Christopher Nolan Batman.
Okay.
Whereas I think I want to go the other way and be...
You want to go a bit of a dark Batman.
Yeah.
Nice. I think that's what I like about it. You get to be the Batman that you want to be.
Hmm.
And I think that's what I like about it. I mean, I'm sure everything sort of wraps up eventually in the same way towards the end of the game. But I think that it's cool that you get to do it how you want to do it. And there is sort of... And I love that about the Telltale games.
Yeah, it's awesome. Mine's get back on. I need to do a darn Batman as well. Yeah. At some point.
Yeah.
What have I been playing? I'm playing a lot, actually. I've been off this week. Let's see. I'm playing some VR stuff. I'm playing PlayStation VR Worlds, which I got for Christmas. I like The London Heist. It's awesome. Danger Ball's a lot of fun. But Scavenger's Odyssey made me want to throw up. The motion in that is just, oh god, so awful. I don't know what they've done to it. But I was fine at first, but like jumping between platforms and like, at one point in like zero gravity and jumping like up and like turning midair, that just felt awful. It's like 10 minutes of that, I was like, oh nope, I'm done, this is it. I take my headset off and I felt like crap the rest of the day.
That's the problem with it doesn't feel natural, and I think that's what messes you up. Like, I tried it as well, and I was okay for the first bit, you know, where you used like the gravity things to pull the door down and stuff. I was like, okay, this is fine, but then you get past that and you jump into platforms and you're like, this does not feel right.
I agree,
I mean, they give you the like the illusion of sitting down in the mech, but it still doesn't feel natural.
Yeah, it doesn't. I agree. That's a shame, but there's some good stuff on there. What else? I'm playing Super Stardust Ultra VR, which is very cool. Super Stardust is a great game. I've been playing it since the PS3. It's the best PS3 game I've played. So that's very cool in VR. What else? More Overwatch, obviously. More Final Fantasy 15. More Paper Mario. Yeah, that's about it, honestly.
Okay.
Yeah, it's more usual stuff, plus some VR stuff.
Fair enough. I've been playing a bit of FIFA. I've been playing a lot online. I've got it on Xbox now as well, so I've been sort of flipping between the two. I've been playing quite a lot, but now that I'm here to talk about it, I can't remember what I've been playing.
So
I have been playing a lot of different things. I've been sort of flicking between Battlefield. I tried the X-Wing VR mission in Star Wars Battlefront.
Oh, yeah.
Which is really awesome.
Oh, cool.
So that's well worth trying if you do have Star Wars Battlefront and a PlayStation VR. It is free, so well worth trying.
Awesome.
What else have I been playing? I started Game of Thrones on Xbox.
Oh, yeah.
The Telltale series, which is cool so far. Being somebody who doesn't watch the series, it doesn't really matter. Sort of like The Walking Dead, because it doesn't throw you into TV stuff. Mm. It like shows you a different side of it.
That's cool.
So it starts at the other side of the Red Wedding. I only knew what this was because I had to ask Lottie. So.
Okay, fair enough.
And then, so you're a new family who aren't in the TV series. It's really cool. It was cheap, so it's well worth checking out. I can't even remember what I've been playing. I've been playing loads and I can't even remember. Gears of War with you.
Oh, of course, yeah, Gears
of War. I've been playing an awful lot of that. I've been playing the Blizzard Mountain on Forza Horizon 3, which is great.
Nice.
Really, really good. They put a lot of effort into those DLC packs that they bring out with sort of every iteration of Forza Horizon.
Cool.
But I've been playing a ton of stuff. There's a load of stuff that I want to get to.
Okay.
Like, when we talked about Gravity Rush last week, now I've re-downloaded it to my console with the intention of playing it.
Yeah.
Whether it happens or not is another thing. I started Uncharted 3.
Oh, yeah, that's what I've
seen. Started a live playthrough of that, which is cool. I did about 2.5 hours of the night, and cool. I forgot how good it was.
It's a great game.
So I'm looking forward to playing that.
Excellent.
And I've played some more of The Last of Us Remastered as well. I picked that back up.
Awesome.
Which, by the way, it seems to have had a graphical upgrade because it is fucking unbelievable.
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
Yeah.
I played it, and the cutscenes, you know, where like just before you meet Ellie,
oh yeah,
and you're with you're Joel, and you're with the woman that you're with.
Yeah, Lily. His name, I can't remember.
Yeah, I can't remember her name.
Yeah,
but like the graphics on like Joel and his facial movements and stuff like that. It's like, has this had some sort of upgrade or something? Because it looks amazing.
Yeah.
Wow. It looks really, really good. So I've been playing a bunch of stuff, and it's all just sort of blended into one. And enjoying a bit of gaming at the minute. I'm trying to get back to try and get through some of the games that I wanted to get through before Resident Evil comes out, before Yakuza comes out, Power Rangers comes out next week. I'm going to play through that.
Morphin Time.
Yeah, I'm so excited.
Yes.
Jesus Christ, I'm excited. Good times for gaming.
Cool.
It's a nice time to get through the backlog, January.
Yeah, yeah. Speaking of just gaming, I'm playing Overwatch a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sort of went into like a brick wall with it a bit.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I don't know if I've hit the skill cap. Skill cap. Like, I'm not getting any better. I'm playing competitive. I'm in platinum. I want to get into diamond. The same thing happened last season as well. I got 2,800, near 3,000 points to get to diamond. And then I'll start a massive losing streak. I'm way back down to early 2000s. And it's like, all right, something's going on here. So I'm thinking I might switch to PC version, which would suck because I'm going to get back down to level 1, losing all my skins.
Oh, you nerd.
I know, but it's like...
Now you've got glasses. You want to switch into PC.
I know, right? But it's like, I don't know. It just seems so much smoother and the community's better on PC. I don't know. I'm tempted.
I will call you a nerd on every single podcast.
I know. It's just... I don't know. Maybe I will.
What do you think it is? Why do you think you're hitting that wall at that particular level every time?
I don't know. It's weird. I don't know if it's just like the people I'm playing against are all... I don't even know what it is.
Okay.
The same thing, it reminds me of like when I played Street Fighter 4. Like I play online and that, I'll be really good up to a point, and then I get to like a certain level and then I had to get my ass kicked and back down to like early levels. It's like, oh, I must have hit my wall, my skill wall.
Right, fair enough.
Yeah. I need to switch it up a bit.
Fair enough.
Yeah, just thought I'd mention that because it's a thing I thought of.
Fair enough. We do have some gaming news this week. Nothing much, but...
It's something you told me, actually, which shocked me, so I'll let you get on with it.
Okay.
So I heard about it.
Xbox and PC exclusive Scalebound, which is made by Platinum Games, has been cancelled.
Yeah.
This has been in development for, a couple of years now?
Yeah, since I think it's one of the first games announced for Xbox One, wasn't it?
No, I think, when they announced like that massive slate of games that included Rise of the Tomb Raider, maybe Halo 5, and a few others. Where they had they called it the greatest lineup in game in Xbox history or something. Oh, yeah, like that. Yeah. That was part of it, I think. But out of the blue, cancelled.
Yeah, strange.
Never to be seen again.
Yeah, weird one. It looked like it'd been come along pretty far as well. They had been shut off like gameplay and stuff a bit. So yeah, it's a weird one.
I don't know what's happening at Platinum at the minute.
I love Platinum.
Obviously they've got a Nier Automata that comes out soon.
Yes.
And it's had nothing but praise for its demo. A lot of people seem to be really looking forward to that.
Yep.
That's like really soon, actually, I think.
Yeah, I think it's March, I think.
Oh, is it still that far away?
Yeah, a couple months, but soonish.
But it's had a lot of praise for its demo and stuff, so hopefully, they'll redeem themselves a little bit with that. But this is a real shock. I was fully expecting... expecting this to come out.
Yeah, same.
Because it got delayed and I thought, fine. That's still going to come because it seems too far along for it not to happen.
Yeah, exactly.
A couple of years in development. But yeah, done for.
Sad. I guess if... I don't know. Who are they owned by now? I think it's... Sega or Sega, isn't it? Is it Sega?
The Platinum.
Yeah.
I want to say yes.
Can't remember, but it's always sad when the game. Yeah, I'll agree with it. It's always sad when the game gets cancelled, especially one made by Platinum, who I loved a bit.
The thing is, this is one of the Xbox exclusives that you're actually looking forward to. Like when we talked about Xbox having good exclusives and stuff like that, you said that Scalebound was one of the ones that you were actually really looking forward to.
Yeah, one of the few. Yeah, and it's sad.
It is really sad. I don't like when games get cancelled anyway, especially big exclusives like Scalebound, but. It's a real mystery. I don't know if we'll, sort of information will start to leak over the next few weeks, maybe even days, as to why it's been cancelled. But I was really shocked when I saw it.
Yeah.
This is a blunder, in my opinion. You found out who Platinum are owned by?
Nope.
I think it is Sega.
Yeah, I might be thinking of someone else.
Let me have a look. I'll Google it. All you have to do is Google Platinum Games.
Yeah, that's what I've done. I'm on the website now.
Right. Sega.
Oh, Sega. Okay, cool.
Yeah, video game publisher Sega announced that it would be publishing 4 unique properties developed by Platinum Games. Mad World, Infinite Space, Bayonetta and Vanquish.
That's a long time ago.
Well, either way. It's owned by somebody, the game's not coming. So.
Yeah.
It's a real shame. It really, really is.
Yeah, I agree.
Speaking of Platinum, actually, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game that Platinum made recently, was published by Activision, has actually been pulled from digital retail stores.
Yeah.
Including PSN, Xbox Live. You can still buy it at retail, but you can't buy it digitally.
Interesting.
This goes for the Activision published Spider-Man games as well. Which are garbage, so...
Yeah, they're not great.
I think this is probably license-related.
Yeah,
may even reappear, depending on sort of if they renew the licenses or whatever.
Yeah, because Deadpool went away for a while, didn't it? And that came back in the end.
Yeah, Deadpool did go away for a while and came back. Yeah. With the Spider-Man one, that might not come back, because obviously Sony have that IP now.
Yeah.
It's going to be a PlayStation 4 exclusive.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Made by Insomniac, I'm really excited for.
Yeah, same.
It's coming this year, apparently.
Was it?
I'm not sure if that's ambitious or not, but...
I don't know.
Also, if it does come this year.
Yeah.
The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle games that Platinum made was terrible.
Yeah, I heard it wasn't great.
It was a piece of shit, that's what it was.
Yeah, I think it was rushed by Activision, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think it was... there's a film coming out, make sure you get it out. And they were like, it's not about that.
Yeah.
It isn't about the film.
We want to make a good game. So, no time. Just whatever.
Fine. They put the trailers out, and I was like, this is fucking awesome. This is the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game that I won.
Yeah.
I played it, and it's a real piece of shit.
Yeah, it's a shame.
Yeah. If you wanted to try it, Steve, it's on your, it'll be on your PS4.
Yeah, you're really selling it to me.
I mean,
I can give it a try. It's not going to cost me anything, is it?
So. I tried to play it again fairly recently, and I did a couple of the bosses, and I had a little bit of fun with it. But I think with another person, it might actually be okay.
Mm.
But yeah. By yourself, it's not a fun game. The AI isn't good. Weird story. There's too much going on that's unexplained, and it just isn't a good game. So if you missed it at digital, you can still buy it at retail. But do you want my advice? Don't bother.
Yeah.
So from games that have been pulled and a game that's been cancelled to a game that is coming and coming soon,
yay.
Mass Effect Andromeda has been given an official release date of March the 21st, 2017.
Wow, very soon.
So very soon. I think that's nailed on now. That's no way that's getting delayed now.
I hope you're right.
I think it's too official now.
Mm.
I mean, I was sceptical.
Yeah.
But it's been officially announced now. I think there's no way that gets delayed. Not this close.
I'm tempted to make a bet with you.
Yeah, you think it's going to get delayed past the 21st of March?
I think so. We've seen nothing about this game. At least, like, concept.
But I think EA are going for that. They're trying to not... this game's going to sell anyway.
Yeah.
So that they don't need the hype train behind it. I mean, Sony are fully behind Horizon. That's a brand new IP that needs all the pushing and all that sort of stuff. Mass Effect, I don't think needs it. It's going to sell. You've got a massive, massive fan base for Mass Effect.
It's true.
And I don't think Andromeda needs that sort of enormous sales push. It's coming. I'm certain it's coming March 21st. I don't think it's going to get delayed past that.
Okay. I'm going to make a bet with you.
Okay.
Make a first, second bet of the year.
What was the first?
The one I'm going to lose. It's a women's main event at WrestleMania. It's not happening now.
No, definitely is not.
Yeah. Bad bet, my part. But so I made that bet with you. So
tell me, what do you think is coming?
You
haven't got to give an exact date. If you want to give me a rough date,
fine. I'd say like fall or autumn 20 this year.
Oh, that far?
Yeah, no way. Quite far. I think so. But
no way it's coming. What do you think it's going to come fall this year?
That'd be my prediction. Yeah, if I had to give like an estimate.
Finn, if it's fall...
I mean, I hope I'm wrong. Don't be wrong. I hope it isn't cancelled. I hope it's an amazing game and it's like comes on time and everyone loves it. But
I think it will be amazing and I think it will come on time. I just... now that it's been officially announced like that, I just can't see it being delayed. I know it's happened before, of course, but massive game, a massive franchise. I just can't see it being delayed now, anyway.
Yeah, and I hope you're right, but we'll see.
Another Mass Effect Andromeda tidbit. Okay. No season pass.
All right, okay.
Good news.
Yeah, good. Interesting.
I've noticed it because Titanfall, I don't think, has a season pass. All the content's free, all the DLC packs.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Everything's free. Now, Mass Effect as well, not going to have a season pass. EA stepping in the right direction. Obviously, Battlefield has a bloody expensive season pass.
Yeah.
That's Battlefield and people will buy it. But
Star Wars,
yeah.
Yeah, everyone loves Star Wars.
Everyone does love Star Wars. To be fair, the content they've put out is fairly significant, so.
Yeah, that's fair.
I guess the Battlefield stuff as well, but I never play it, so. Injustice 2, which is one I'm really, really excited for, also has official release date. You can see a recurring theme here. Start of the year, they want to sort of tell you about the games they've got coming out.
Yeah.
So it has been officially announced by Warner Brothers, and the guy, I can't even remember his fucking name, the one who works for NetherRealm. Ed Boon,
yeah, that's it.
yeah, that's coming 16th of May 2017, so that's only a few months off as well.
Nice.
That's going to be awesome. I love the first one.
Yeah,
cool. I love Mortal Kombat X.
Yeah.
So that's going to be fantastic.
Awesome.
Really, really good game. Is the Shenmue HD collection coming? Steve, tweeted this to us the other day. Sega, I mean, this doesn't necessarily mean it's coming, and it's too fucking late for you now anyway.
Yeah, I know.
So I hope it's coming.
So close. So close.
Yeah, I know, so close.
Sega have registered a couple of domain names. Mm. One is ShenmueHD.com.
Yay.
The other is ShenmueRemastered.com.
Ooh, even better.
Could we see an announcement soon? I think so.
I hope so.
I mean, just because these domains have been registered doesn't mean they're ever going
to
use them.
No, they could just be doing it to, like, as a make sure no one else gets it. Just make sure they own it.
You're a spiteful bastard if you if you go to Shenmue HD or ShenmueRemastered.com.
Yeah, seriously.
You're going to have to pay me a lot of money, Sega. I hope that's coming.
I still
think they're going to have to jump through hoops to get it out. But,
oh, for sure, yeah.
I mean, Shenmue 3 is either never coming or it's a very long way off.
It's a long, long way off, yeah.
Do you think it's coming, ever?
I think so. Well, the Kickstarter now, so they kind of have to. Oh, that's going to be for everyone.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
Kickstarter projects get cancelled all over the place, even when they've been reached their goal.
That's true. No, I have faith. I have faith it's going to happen.
Oh, I hope you're right.
Yeah.
They need to finish the story. For Christ's sake.
Yeah, it's like 20 odd years, yeah.
Yeah. I bet, you know what, I've forgotten it, so I'd be happy to play through them both again.
Yeah. I've played the first one quite recently on my Dreamcast. But yeah, I'd have to play through it again. It's a great game. I love them.
Super. Yeah. Absolutely outstanding. I hope that's, I do hope it does come.
Yeah.
Both the HD collection and Shenmue 3.
Yes.
Uncharted 4, Sony's gigantic first party release. Is it first party? First part, of course it is.
Yeah, that's
me. Sold a massive 8.7 million copies.
Wow.
Since launch.
Bloody hell. Nice.
That is a shitload of copies.
It is. Good job.
And it just shows how, I mean, there's so many PlayStation 4s in the world.
Mm.
Much more than that. It should have sold more. Yeah. That's a shitload of games. That's a shitload of copies.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Awesome. Good job, Naughty Dog.
And it's the last one.
Oh, really? Not many more.
What, Uncharted?
Yeah, I mean, I thought they might. I don't know. Uncharted 5.
I think they need to give it a rest for a while.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, they do.
Maybe if they're gonna do it on PlayStation 5.
Yeah.
Obviously, they've got the DLC coming out soon.
Yeah, of course you got that.
Which I'm excited for. Which is gonna be awesome. Steve, you never played Uncharted, have you?
No. No, I haven't.
You definitely should.
I will. I've got a little bit of a backlog. What I call a backlog. Because I've just bought Ratchet and Clank as well,
nice.
Which I've got to mention.
Oh, yeah! You played it. How did you find it?
Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, it's just a fun game.
Yeah.
The graphics are incredible.
Yeah, the graphics are absolutely amazing. I couldn't quite get over it. And the storyline so far is quite... It's got a bit of humour in it. And it's, you know, it's fairly straightforward to play. And already encountered a couple of frustrating bits, but... You know, it's just a fun game, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really, really good.
I didn't obviously knew of it, didn't play it before. You know, so it reminded me a lot of Crash Bandicoot, which I know you've mentioned before on the podcast. So yeah, I'm looking forward to playing through it.
Yeah, and finishing. It's really, really good. It's not overly long.
No,
I made a real meal of it by taking fucking ages to play through it. But
yeah.
I mean, when I picked it back up again, I finished it like within 2 days. So
nice.
And that was just a few hours of time playing it. So it's probably you could probably get 10 hours out of it. I think depends how.
Probably about 15 for me then. Usually add half on again for me for I'm useless at those sort of, because it is a bit out of my comfort zone, to be honest.
Depends how you play it, because there's stuff to collect all over the place. So depending on whether you go wandering around, like, because some of the areas are pretty big. I mean, it is a fairly linear game as far as playing through it.
Yeah.
But the areas are pretty big, and the secrets and stuff to find. So it depends on how you want to play it. I mean, I'm going to play through it again and then do the stuff that I missed.
Cool. Yeah, I mean, if I enjoy it enough, I'll probably do the same.
Yeah.
You know, because as you know, I did with the South Park game, so I loved it that much. I played through it twice.
That's this year as well.
Oh, yeah. Yes, because that got
awesome.
Yeah, that got put back, didn't it?
That got pushed. To be fair, that was close, man. That got pushed.
Yeah, close.
I mean, it was same year.
Oh yeah.
I thought that was nailed on as well. Because I mean, they were like, right, it's coming out Christmas. Right, okay.
And especially because the latest series of South Park, which I believe has just finished, was sponsored by the game on Comedy Central. Okay. So it was like that was always in the pipeline. You know, because when the series was on, the game would have been due to come out like weeks before, a couple of weeks before, and it would have come out while the series was on.
Makes sense.
Sponsorship was there and everything, but obviously the game got pushed back.
It's only a couple of months away though.
Yeah.
South Park, the Fractured Butthole. It's going to be awesome. I'm really excited for that as well.
Yeah.
Going back to Ratchet and Clank, it is excellent. I did say it's one of the PlayStation 4's best, and I do firmly believe that as well. It's awesome.
Awesome.
So stick at it. It's not overly long as far as story goes. It is a kid's game after all. And the budget title, incredibly. I still can't believe that. Could have easily charged £60 for it.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
what was I talking about before we were talking about Ratchet and Clank? Oh, Uncharted.
Oh, yeah.
So I think if there's games that I was to recommend you play, Those four games are definitely it.
Yeah.
I mean, even one scrubs up very nicely in the Nathan Drake collection, I think. And two and three are just fucking awesome. And four's amazing as well.
Yeah.
Two's a masterpiece. And The Last of Us as well. You have to play through The Last of Us. You have to play through The Last of Us. In fact, play through The Last of Us and then play Uncharted. Last of Us is a modern masterpiece. And there's there aren't many better games.
Yep. Agreed.
Ever made.
Yep. I agree with that.
Yeah.
Definitely up there.
If you were to place The Last of Us would it make a top 10 list of your best games of all time?
I think so. It's definitely, it's close, if not in it, yeah, for sure.
Mm.
I have to have time to think, I'll probably sit down and think about my top 10 if I had to make a top 10 list, but it would definitely be up there, for sure.
Yeah. It's so good. I can't believe how good it is. Like, no matter how many times you play it, like, you love the characters and the story's amazing and the gameplay's incredible and it's just...
Everything blends together so perfectly in that game as well.
Mm.
What's
great is it could have been Uncharted again.
Yeah.
Like, with a different story, but it isn't. It's got obviously some of the same... It's got the Naughty Dog mechanics in there, but it adds it's a slower pace and it adds crafting and stuff like that in it. So it's just awesome.
Yep.
Play through that. It's amazing.
For sure.
So again,
another game on my PSN download list for you. Cool. So you've got my Steve has my PlayStation login, so he plays the games that I buy.
Yeah, okay.
So it's good times.
Good times.
It's just made the list.
Yeah. made the list of games that Steve has to play.
Yes.
Because we have to.
Do we have to?
That's what this segment should be called now.
Because we have to,
This segment should be called Because We Have To. Let's skim through, Rob, because again, it was a Roman Reigns, Jericho, Kevin Owens, Seth Rollins fest.
Yeah.
Braun Strowman. It's been added to the mix there.
Oh, yeah. There was one good thing that happened this week on Raw, which we'll get to.
Yeah, and it should have happened weeks ago.
Raw
was another shit show. I'm just going to... It was.
Yep, it was. In every sense of the words.
How would you sum it up, Finn?
Pretty garbage. Except for the ending.
Steve?
Hot garbage.
Yep, right, good. So we're all in agreement that Raw was terrible again this week. Now, if you heard last week's podcast, you will have heard me tear Raw a new one.
Yep.
And it deserves it.
Yeah.
And I speak to a friend of mine, and I was like, I tore Raw a new one on the podcast. And he went, well, yeah, because it's crap. And I was like, yes, it is. It's terrible.
Yeah.
I just don't get it. I just don't understand how it can be such a bad program.
Yeah,
no, not me.
It started off so well with the brand split, and then
I know.
So ever since Finn Balor got injured, it's like it's just gone downhill. It's like
Steve, you skim through War every week. Tell me what you think about.
I skim through it every week, but recently, the thing that frustrates me with Raw the most is this need to fill 3 hours. And I know we've gone over this, so I won't go into.
But it deserves to be gone over again and again because it just, that's the most frustrating part.
So I tell you what I absolutely hate, and I think, and this doesn't help, I was thinking about this earlier with the flow of how it goes, and I know they have to do it because of TV, is the breaks, the ad breaks, I know it's live, so they have to have these ad breaks, but it doesn't help with the flow of things, and what really annoys me and what really gets my back up is they'll have a match on, a really average match. Two wrestlers you don't care about for whatever reason, either they're garbage or there's just no context behind their match, and then it will cut to a backstage segment which will be crap, and then you'll have someone come out for their match and you'll have the whole entrance, then you'll have the opponent come out, and then it will get to a bloody break.
Yeah.
Right? And then it goes to a break, and then it comes back, and they go, oh, and we've been joined by so-and-so.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, right, so in the ad break, and not only have we had to then endure an ad break, and it's, thank God for Sky Plus, because at least we can fast-forward it.
Raw would be unbearable if we didn't have Sky Plus.
Oh, God, yeah.
I think this is why it was better back in the day, because obviously, back in the day, we didn't have Sky Plus, so they used to show it live, obviously, on a Monday night. We didn't get to watch it until Friday.
Yeah.
And by then, they'd condensed it down. And it was a two-hour show then as well. But they'd condensed it down. It didn't have all the ad breaks in.
Yeah, they put the ad breaks in normal places.
In normal places, in natural sort of breaks.
So even if they sort of said, who will win this match? Find out when we come back. It would literally go, it would fade out and fade straight back in.
Yeah. Or it would go to a WWE related or WWF, whatever it was then, related thing, which I guess is what they get in America. They don't get the ads that we get.
Well, they'll get
a couple of their ads, but they'll get a few WWE networky stuff.
Well, you notice that, so when they cut to breaks, they go, "Now we're going to take a quick look at WWE Hall of Famer Edge." And I thought, "Oh, okay, I wonder what this is for." And then it cuts to a normal advert.
So that annoys me. It doesn't help with the it doesn't help with the flow of it. So that's what pees me off about Raw, to be honest. It's just the length of it, the ad breaks. And like you say, this Jericho, Owens, Reigns, Rollins, who as four individual wrestlers, I actually really like. Even Roman Reigns.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not a Roman Reigns hater, by any stretch. But I'm bored of seeing it now.
I am.
Yeah. Same.
It's just become a problem, and I think it's putting a lot of WWE fans off watching the product.
Not only that, I don't. When it's as bad as that, how do they expect to attract new fans?
Well, yeah, that's it.
As well, like if I was 10 years old and my friends were like, "Yeah, watch wrestling," I watched it. Even at 10 years old, I'd be like, "That's boring."
Yeah, nothing happens.
You know, I don't get how they can attract new fans when it's like that.
I know.
In this format or whatever. But again, it's like deja vu, because 12 months ago I came onto your podcast and we were talking about how bad Raw was. SmackDown wasn't really a thing then, because it was pre-brand split.
Chances are we didn't even watch it.
No. Yeah, and we were saying how bad Raw was then. So, I don't know. I don't know what they can do.
Finn, what do you think?
I don't think we're about the pacing. I think to give matches more time, because a lot of the time it's just like the Cruiserweight, for example. They have I said this last week, but they have 2 minute matches and then it's over. And we want people to care about the Cruiserweights, give them long matches, give them the kind of matches they were having on the Cruiserweight Classic. No one's going to care about them if we give them 2 minute matches and it's over and it ends by DQ or some bollocks. And you've got bloody.
Yeah, it almost seems to me the frustrating thing is the purpose of the Cruiserweights on Raw is to promote 205 Live.
Yeah.
But then, why would you care about 205 Live if the matches on Raw are pointless?
Exactly. Yeah.
That's not the Cruiserweights' fault.
No,
it's
Cruiserweights' booking. Great.
Of course it's the booking.
To be fair, for me, the Cruiserweights were Jack Gallagher was the only shining light of Raw this week.
Yeah.
Because his segments are...
His segments are brilliant.
They're quite funny. And the crowd actually seemed to like him.
Yeah.
I mean, already... I mean, was Neville in a match?
Yes, he was.
He won. He won. No reaction.
Yeah.
2 weeks ago, the crowd were chanting, "Thank you, Neville," because it was we've got someone that's going to come back, someone we know, blah, blah, blah. And now it's he's won, and we don't care already.
It was almost right, Lindsay, you go out there, do some flippy floppy stuff, show the crowd what you're all about, give them some oohs and ahs. Neville's going to beat you with submission.
Okay. A submission that they didn't know the name of. It's like a Rings of Saturn.
You know, it is, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And I can't remember, I think it was on Raw as well. Didn't Michael Cole say Jack Gallagher, didn't he mix the two names up? Was it that match? Or there might have been another match where he mixed the two names up.
The best bit of commentary on Raw this week was when Austin Aries says, "Hopefully the person who wins this match can actually afford to go out and buy some knee pads."
Oh, yeah.
Yes, that was funny. Yeah.
Austin Aries is absolutely awesome. He's great. I can't wait for... they're doing that right. They're giving him that exposure on Raw so that the people who don't watch NXT and obviously didn't watch TNA or whatever, they know who he is before he jumps on when he comes back from injury. He will then jump into the Cruiserweight division. People will know who he is. So that's smart booking.
Very smart.
Smart taking off Daenerys on comms. And he's good as well. He's funny.
He's great. Well, he's got carrying a banana around with him recently.
He's been doing that on NXT as well.
Yeah. Weird.
I think it was a running joke. He did it once on NXT and someone caught him.
He was interviewed, wasn't he? And he had a banana and the cameras, and then he had to sort of go, "Oh, I'm just going to go and eat my banana now." And now it's become this thing. It's an accidental thing that's become a thing.
That's funny. I'm good at that.
The problem with Raw is the pacing of the matches. There's no real structure to it, and you've got too many people doing nothing that people can care about.
Yeah.
Like we talked about New Day before we came on doing this.
Yeah.
And it was like, sure the Titus O'Neil falling over video is funny, but yeah. What are they doing? The booty juice catchphrase, it was unplanned and they didn't know what the hell was going on.
Yeah, can't remember it.
No, exactly.
Yeah.
Like, booty-os, they make sure you ain't booty. Yeah. That's catchy and funny.
Was it booty juice, it makes sure your throat is loose?
Yeah, that was it. But Big E didn't know it, and Xavier Woods did know it, and they tried to do it together, and it just didn't work. It's like, what on earth are you doing? Yeah. You've gone from being the tag team champions, the longest reigning tag team champions, and being really entertaining every week, and now you're doing this, and it's like, well, this is crap.
So can I go for a prediction that next week's Raw is Titus O'Neil against Big E?
I was thinking that as well. They've had him versus Xavier, they've had him versus Kofi, and now it makes sense just to drag it out a bit longer to have him versus Big E. Yeah.
And then I'm guessing after that, he'll announce himself into the Royal Rumble, because those three are in it, aren't they?
I guess. Are they really?
Yeah, I think so.
Yes. I think all three are in.
Right.
So.
They're wasted Royal Rumble slots, in my opinion.
Yes.
What they need to do is...
I'd prefer that than bring some like legend back, legend in the loosest sense, you know.
But I like that.
See, I know we're going off topic a bit, but I was thinking about this earlier. And
Raw's crap anyway, we don't need to talk about it.
Yeah, it's fine.
I liked last year's Rumble more so because it didn't have that.
Did we have any in there last year?
No.
Not at all?
No.
Best thing about last year's Royal Rumble, of course, was AJ Styles.
Yeah.
And them cutting to Roman Reigns just as easy.
Yeah, well done.
I just think, like, you could have Rollins, Reigns, Jericho in there. That's three. Mm-hmm. Like Strowman, Sammy, people who could actually win it. Like, Xavier Woods isn't going to win the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, probably not.
I have mixed feelings about the Royal Rumble. I love it in the sense that it's the Royal Rumble and it's great, but let's be honest, when was the last time we were happy with the result of the Royal Rumble?
Good point, yeah.
The only reason we were sort of pleased last year is so that Reigns didn't win the Royal Rumble, or whoever it was. Triple H came back and he won the belt, didn't he?
Yeah.
Which we predicted months in advance.
Yeah, we actually did, didn't we? We said months in advance that it was going to be Triple H who wins it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Anyway, going back to Raw, it's just garbage, and I don't know what needs to change. Well, I do know what needs to change. It needs to go back to 2 hours, but I can't beat that drum enough. And that's,
it's not going to happen, sadly.
It needs better structure. It needs less Mick Foley, less Stephanie McMahon. What's that?
This is my notes. Because watching just skipping through it, being pissed off at Raw. That's just what the notes I've devolved into. One of my notes is, Kofi versus Titus, Kofi wins, or whatever. What's got the Undertaker coming back? Mr. Old McSpooky is back.
Yeah.
And the Arena Rumble. One watches it on the telly. Something, something, rest in peace.
And then he snorts, like, rest.
That was weird. I rewound that because I thought, did I just hear that? He's never done that before. I mean, I enjoyed that bit, the start of it, just from a nostalgia point of view. Yeah. When he was stood at the top of the ramp and the camera was quite a way off and he looked huge, he looked massive.
He's gonna win the Royal Rumble.
He looked really authoritative, yeah.
Kenny Omega's
and I thought that's pretty cool.
Kenny Omega's gonna win the Royal Rumble, please.
Yeah, fair enough.
See, when someone's talking about, when people are talking about John Cena's Instagram post more than they are Raw or SmackDown, that sort of tells you where Raw and SmackDown are.
Raw was terrible. There was a load of, like, Undertaker's going to be in the Royal Rumble. Yep, fine. But it needs to be 2 hours. No Mick Foley because he's not good at this authority role that he's got. Less Stephanie McMahon, even though she is way better at it than what Mick Foley is.
She's going to heal, yeah, for sure.
But it needs better structure. Have an actual direction for the tag team division. Have an actual direction for the US title. And have a main event scene that centres around that championship. Yeah. Not a fucking shark cage for the sake of selling a toy. It's just mind-blowing nonsense. And it just seems like SmackDown does have structure. It just seems like two completely different shows. But let's talk about the one thing that was good from Raw that should have happened weeks ago.
Yes. So at the start of the show, there was supposed to be a 2-on-1 handicap match for the US title. So Kevin Owens and Jericho versus Roman Reigns. But obviously Braun Strowman interrupted. Mass demo started, Seth Rollins came down to help, blah, 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 whatever. So the match got delayed until later in the night. Yeah, it was a decent match, actually. Probably the best match of the night. Not the most competition. Jericho ended up winning the US title. So he's now a Grand Slam champion because he's won all the belts throughout his career, which is cool.
Very cool.
And it still happened, as you said, weeks ago. But I'm glad it's off Roman Reigns, finally.
The thing is, you know what's going to happen next week, right? We're going to have
rematch.
That rematch.
Yeah. Please let me back.
Have it'll be the same sort of crappy stuff. Yeah. It'll be... So whether they take... I don't want them to go down that road of Roman Reigns winning it back away.
They won't. They'll just have Kevin Owens come in and DQ and they'll retain it that way or something.
Yeah.
One Stone will come down and punch him in the face. Who cares?
Yeah, seriously.
Something will happen. They won't. They can win it back on Reigns, surely.
See, now that their belt is off Reigns and onto Jericho, hopefully this will give some of your mid-carders a bit of a chance. You know, your Sami Zayn's and I would say Cesaro and Sheamus, but they're, you know, they're tag teaming it, aren't they?
Yeah.
So, yeah, hopefully, you know, because we've said this before, you can't have someone like Sami Zayn just go up against Roman Reigns and win the US title. So now it's on Jericho, it's going to be more believable. If that was the direction they went in.
Agreed. But this to me just stinks of Reigns leaving the Royal Rumble with that belt.
Oh yeah.
I don't think there's a question about it.
Yeah, you're probably right.
I think the Royal Rumble is it's setting up to be a good show, fine, and people have been hyping it on the internet, really looking forward to it for some reason because Raw's been garbage. I am glad that Jericho's won the US title and, you know, he will lose it, when he's about to leave or whatever. But the Royal Rumble for me, Cena will beat AJ, Taker will win the Rumble, Taker will challenge Cena at WrestleMania for the title, Taker will win the title at WrestleMania have one last run with the championship.
That'd be cool, yeah. I can see that happening.
That's the worst of it. You can see it happening, and
you predicted like 3 months in advance, yeah.
Yeah. But that just seems to me what's going to happen. And then they'll build up. Reigns will have that belt for a while. But in fact, he might even have it because the Raw title won't be the Universal title won't be the main event at WrestleMania. It'll be the Cena versus Taker.
Yeah.
Because that is a main event.
And everyone wants to see that.
And it'll be good because Cena puts good matches on, regardless of what people want to believe. Roman Reigns will carry that belt for a long time.
Yeah, I'm kind of disappointed with Kevin Owens' run because he had all the potential in the world to be amazing, but they just lumbered him with this crap storyline and as much as I like the Chris Jericho Kevin Owens thing, it's very funny, but it's not. Kevin Owens can put on great matches, and they're not letting him. Which is a shame.
Yeah.
Too much nonsense. That's what, I said it a few weeks back, they need to hit reset on Kevin Owens now.
Yeah, you're right.
And it's not through any fault of his own, and it's a real shame that he's had the title. He wouldn't have had the title anyway because Finn Balor would have had it.
Well, that's true, yeah.
And I firmly believe Finn Balor will have it again.
Oh, for sure.
Some point in the near future, but I say in the near future, I see Roman Reigns holding that belt for a long time if he wins it at the Royal Rumble.
Yes.
So he'll be defended halfway down the card at WrestleMania.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
First match, honestly.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, possibly. But I think he'll be defended halfway down the card, or first match on at WrestleMania. And I think Reigns will just keep it from the Royal Rumble past WrestleMania, because they won't have both titles change hands at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And then Roman Reigns will just carry up. But it needs a strong run. So if Roman Reigns is going to bat off all comers and make the title look prestigious, because Kevin Owens hasn't, because it's just cheating to win every week. What's the point? That's what I think will happen, but who am I?
Well,
there is with Raw, I have got a little bit of, if it's done right, I've got a little bit of faith that it could become half decent again.
Okay, what are you thinking?
I just think there's potential storylines that don't involve a belt, but there's potential storylines that you would look forward to if they're not dragged on for 3-4 months in a row. So that stat that you came out with last week, like the last 22 episodes of Raw have involved them for.
Yeah.
Which is ridiculous. But
that's crazy.
But, you know, let's go back to the old format of a rivalry goes from pay-per-view to pay-per-view,
mm-hmm.
and then it's over. Or it might spill into another pay-per-view.
At
most. So I still think there's a Seth Rollins Triple H thing coming.
I think that's nailing on for WrestleMania.
Yeah, I do as well.
Triple H will have his yearly WrestleMania match, and I think it's just completely nailed on to be Seth Rollins. Sure.
You've got Finn Balor coming back. He's going to go straight into the
title. When's he due?
I don't know.
People are saying him coming back to the Rumble, but I think that might be too soon.
And him winning the Rumble just doesn't fit with me.
Doesn't fit with everything.
I think he's coming back during the Rumble. He'd have to win it. Just makes me think it's not going to happen because, as you say, it's probably going to be Undertaker or someone.
Yeah.
So perhaps not.
Yeah, and I want to see the club win tag team titles.
Yes.
You know, and I want them to be absolute mud. I just want them to destroy. You know, and then maybe bring someone up from NXT. You know, for them to then take it off the club.
The titles.
Yeah.
So like revival, or
yeah, someone like that. But I'm talking like in. So you know, have the club win the tag team titles at the Rumble, if it's a match, and then let them have it for ages past WrestleMania. Have them win at WrestleMania, you know, and then bring someone up from NXT and have them, you know, so you get to a point where the club have had it for ages and they look absolutely monstrous, and then someone young and upcoming wins it. So there is potential there. It's just whether it's booked right.
Mm-hmm. The potential is absolutely there. They've got the talent for it to get right, you know. I agree. The club should have won the titles so long ago.
Yeah.
But obviously, they were hell bent on New Day breaking the record for Vince's own personal reasons.
Yeah.
Fine. But this year, the club needs to, after WrestleMania, they need a bit of a reset.
Yeah. Maybe they should add another member to the club. Bring someone up with NXT, maybe.
If they were going to do anything with the club, if they were going to do this, this is what I would do. If they were going to bring Kenny Omega in, I would have him run the club.
That'd be amazing. Yeah.
I'd absolutely have him come in and run the club.
Yeah. For sure.
And just take over. I know it's been done, but it was done 20 years ago, so you can do the NWR again.
Oh, yeah.
You can make the club. I mean, you can't call it the Bullet Club. Exactly. For me, the Bullet Club itself doesn't have the same effect that it did before. I mean, you know, like, A year or so ago, there's Bullet Club t-shirts everywhere.
Yeah.
Now, I don't think it's as big a deal as it was.
Mm.
I mean, now the leaders keep changing. You know, it was AJ Styles, then it was Kenny Omega. Yeah. Now it's the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes, and
you've got the Elite.
You've got the Elite, and you've got the Bullet Club Hunters, and it's just a very weird sort of scene. So, I mean, you could bring it over to WWE, not necessarily as the Bullet Club, but you can make a massive group. You could have, Jesus, Finn Balor won't be, but he could be a monster heel.
He could be, yeah, it'd be amazing.
Won't be, because he's too marketable.
Yeah. Too good looking.
But, exactly. But Kenny Omega, no one knows who he is.
Exactly, yeah.
At least, I know what I mean by that.
Yeah, I know who he is.
He's a household name with people like us. He's not a household name with the kids who watch Raw.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I've heard of him.
Yeah.
But when Cena put that picture up, I thought it was bloody Adam Sandler from The Wedding Singer.
Yeah.
I was like, is Adam Sandler going to be in the Royal Rumble? That's a turn off of the books.
Yeah.
Russo back on booking? I mean, bloody hell.
That's what I would do. I mean, Kenny Omega's contract with New Japan expires on January the 31st, so 2 days after the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, so he won't be in the Rumble, will he?
Won't be in the Rumble, but I mean, could Kenny Omega go to WWE? Possibly.
Maybe.
Who knows? But there's so much potential for that to happen. Should he? Absolutely.
Yes.
Should WWE bring him in? He'd be the number one on my list to bring in.
For sure. I love him.
Bring something different. And, that's what I would do with if they were going to do a faction type thing. It's not been a good faction for a while. Not like a proper dominant faction.
No.
They tried it with AJ Styles in the club, but they clearly have bigger ideas for AJ Styles. So,
yeah.
There is a lot of potential. You're right. I mean, when Jericho loses the US title, normal business will be resumed in the mid card with that title.
Yeah.
And I think you'll see Sammy win it. And, there'll be, you know, it'll, there's people in the mid-card now that I'd like to take the step up, but I think Sammy needs the US title.
Yeah, I think so.
Some sort of run like that. Rusev, take a step out, move into the main event.
Yeah. Cool. Yep.
Yeah.
Tag team titles, yeah, you've got the club. There's a load of good tag teams.
Mm-hmm.
They need to decide what they're going to do with Enzo and Cass, so either a tag team or not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you can stick Enzo in the cruiserweights.
Yeah, sure. I guess so, yeah.
Put Big Cass in the main event, or in the mid-card, or whatever.
Yeah, Enzo Cass is a weird one.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's going to be a big year for Cass, Rusev,
hope so.
Owens, hopefully.
Hopefully.
In fact, no, he's already had a big year. So, Rusev and Cass, I think they've got potential to have big years.
Hmm.
Braun Strowman, of course.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
But Raw needs sorting out is the long and short of it. I know we've sort of gone the long way around, but that's what needs to happen.
Agreed. Needs fixing.
Let's move on to SmackDown.
Okay. Not as good as last week, in my opinion. Better than Raw. Not that difficult, but... yeah. So let's blaster it.
All we do is moan about WWE on this podcast.
Pretty much, yeah. What do we talk wrestling?
We talk video games, and we love video games. I guess the WWE are like, why don't we watch this? Usually we're very positive about SmackDown as well, because it has a clear direction, usually.
It does. To start with the Ambrose Asylum, obviously. Dean gives Miz back his participation award. Miz attacked him. Dean hit Dave Leeds. Says it bluff late tonight. Natalya had a match with Nikki Bella. Nikki attacked Natalya before the match. Natalya got the upper hand, attacking her legs, and then like chops her outside the ring. That was the thing. That feud's going to continue, obviously.
Yep, Nikki had the shortest.
I was just about to say that as well.
Yeah.
yeah.
There's no bum wiggle, but made up with it in the short shorts.
Cheers, Natty. Now.
we had Kalisto versus the now heel Dolph Ziggler. Kalisto won with a roll up out of nowhere, and then Dolph attacked him after the match. And then Apollo Crews came down to help, and then got beaten up for his trouble. So that was good.
That'd be on the pre-show of the Royal Rumble. Apollo Crews versus Dolph Ziggler.
Yep.
Coming to the pre-show near you.
Then we had the American Alpha versus the Wyatts rematch for their WWE Tag Team titles. American Alpha won with a roll-up after Luke Harper accidentally cost Randy Orton. A
lot of roll-ups.
A lot of roll-ups, yeah.
How did we finish this match? No idea. Oh, no, roll-up. Okay,
just do roll-up, yeah.
So and, the dissension is already starting to show there.
Yes. Yeah. Harper accidentally kicked Bray Wyatt, aiming for Randy.
I've no doubt in my mind that WrestleMania is going to be Randy Orton versus Bray Wyatt.
Oh, for sure. Definitely.
What do you think?
I don't know. I was wondering whether it will be Harper versus Orton.
Could be.
I thought you were going for Harper versus Wyatt then.
No, it depends which way it sort of breaks down and which side Wyatt goes with.
Yeah.
I think after being kicked in the face, I'm not sure now.
Yeah, true.
I think no side, and they should just break up completely, because Bray Wyatt needs a singles run. This is a make or break year for Bray Wyatt, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Because he's been doing too little for too long.
He keeps entering these big feuds and then just losing.
Yeah.
I'd absolutely love to see him win the IC title. It'd be brilliant.
I'd love to see him win the world title. I think he's so good.
He's brilliant.
He could carry that championship, and it wouldn't even be a problem.
Yeah, I agree.
He has pretty much got it all, really.
Yeah.
He's great on the mic. His promos are fantastic, if not a little bit weird. And they're all his ideas as well, apparently. So he's a bit weird, isn't he? And he is a really good wrestler. He's for his size, he's athletic. I mean, he's got technical ability. He's got a finishing move that people love, and they like people go, the crowd react when he gets them into that position before he does this Sister Abigail. And I agree. You know, any title run would be good because he's just.
This definitely is a make or break year for him. And what I think needs to happen is the Wyatt family need to break up for him to have a run. Because Luke Harper should be winning a mid-card title.
Oh, yeah, he's great.
Randy Orton is Randy Orton. I don't count him as a Wyatt anyway, even though I've not really minded this as it's gone on.
Yeah, it's been alright.
But Bray Wyatt needs to be on his own now. It's been going on for too long. Eric Rowan will be released before long.
Yeah,
I think he'll get released this year.
Yeah.
When do they normally do it? It's a certain time of the year, isn't it? They usually bring the release list out.
Yeah. Is it around the financial year, just after?
Is it after Mania?
Yeah, after Mania, yeah.
So, yeah, April.
Yeah, right. It's around the financial year, isn't it, I think? Mm. Contracts are up or whatever. I mean, Roman's had a lot of injuries, and I just don't see him doing anything. No one likes him. No reaction from the crowd. It's just, he's there. He's a big guy with a black mask. No one cares.
Yeah.
So I think, I do think it'd be Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton. But Bray Wyatt needs to win, and he won't. And that's what I worry about.
That's the problem, isn't it? Any feud he goes into, it doesn't look like he's going to win it.
No, so that's it.
When he got into the Undertaker feud.
Well, he lost straight away.
Yeah, yeah. He did all the build up, all the promos, because Undertaker wasn't at any of them. The first time we saw Taker was at WrestleMania. But like you say, you as soon as that match was announced, you knew that Bray Wyatt had lost it.
Yeah.
It's
You could say it for any feud that he's been in. Bray Wyatt's in this feud, but you know when the payoffs come in, he's not going to be the one to come out of it.
Yeah.
Winning. It's like entering into the feud with Cena. He's going to fight Cena at WrestleMania.
Oh, he's lost then.
Yep, lost that.
Undertaker
lost that, and it's just he needs a good year. He needs to win. He needs to win either the IC title, but I think he should win the big title.
Yeah, I agree.
He's been ready for ages. Yep. Should have won that belt ages ago. Mm. Oh, when he interfered in the main event that time, the Hell in a Cell match that they had.
Oh, with the hologram.
When he came back, yeah. I thought, right, this is it. This is now going to be Bray Wyatt's big time. Yeah, and it wasn't.
He just got entered into a rubbish feud with Ambrose where they had an ambulance match.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
Bizarre. Right. They also announced a Steel Cage Women's Championship match for next week. That'll be obviously Alexa Bliss versus Becky Lynch. Sounds cool.
Do we find out who La Luchadora is soon?
I hope so.
Who is it?
We said Mickie James last week. I still think that's probably the most likely suspect right now.
I saw a picture on Instagram of Alexa and the Lucha, whatever her name is, walking down. I was looking at you can see the eyes and the whatnot and the hand, the skin tone. It's not Naomi, put it that way, but but it's a darker skinned person than.
Well, I think Mickie James is quite tan. She does slap the orange tan on a bit.
Yeah, yeah, possibly.
I did look at her. I mean,
It did look like someone wearing fake tan. Yeah. So I don't know.
She has signed a deal to WWE.
Yeah, it could well be.
But what they could do is they could be plastering her with something to make it not obvious. Look like her.
Maybe, yeah.
I do think it's her. I think it's the most obvious, but it's a weird way to interject her in.
Very weird.
Unless she's going to be a heel.
Yeah. Strange. Weird one.
Yeah.
Or, well, I don't know. I mean, she's going to appear at some point anyway. Put it that way. She'll be in before Mania.
That should be a good match, though.
Yeah,
for sure.
Alexa Bliss.
Yeah, really, really good. I prefer the SmackDown's women's division at the minute to, because now that Charlotte versus Sasha's not a thing, they don't seem to know.
Yeah.
Like, they've got Nia Jax versus Sasha, which Sasha will end up winning because just to show that Sasha can beat the bigger opponent.
Yeah.
And Charlotte will keep that belt until WrestleMania where she'll lose it.
Probably.
She'll lose that pay-per-view winning streak will end at WrestleMania.
Yeah. It makes sense.
Harsh.
Bayley will win it.
Yeah.
I'm not overly sold on Bayley.
I really like Bayley.
I like Bayley.
She's so marketable, it's ridiculous.
Oh, yeah, sure. I know that.
That's why she'll win that belt.
I get all of that. I get all of that. I'm just not myself. I'm just a bit like. Mm.
Yeah, that's fair. But
there's better. Don't get me wrong, there is better, but I do like her.
Yeah, you see.
It's her turn as well.
Yeah. So we had a match with Carmella, a really weird match with Carmella and versus some jobber who looks like Young Mae Young.
What?
You need to see it.
Did you hear what JBL said?
Oh,
she looked like Jack Gallagher's sister. She looks like Susan Boyle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I heard that. I was like, wait, what?
God almighty.
Yeah, weird match. Also, Ellsworth was there because that's a thing.
Sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
He'll be in the Royal Rumble. He'll be the one who gets thrown straight out.
Oh, probably, yeah.
He's going to be that comedy entrant.
He'll be the Santino Morello, yeah.
Yeah. Or he'll throw someone big out.
Yeah, maybe we'll throw more swimming out.
Oh, God.
So we had the main event was Baron Corbin versus John Cena. And yeah, Cena won. Lol. So, yeah.
What do you see AJ Styles doing at WrestleMania?
Good question. Well, AJ Styles on commentary, by the way, for that match.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was weird. Good question. I don't know.
So when's the AJ Cena match?
Royal Rumble.
Is that the Rumble?
Yeah. Maybe bring up Nakamura, AJ versus Nakamura?
Nope, I think Samoa Joe is in AJ Styles' WrestleMania plans.
That'd be equally good.
And I think Samoa Joe will cost AJ the title.
Ooh, that'd be amazing.
So Cena will have the belt, then Taker will win.
They'll turn AJ face, Samoa Joe heel. Samoa Joe has to be the heel when it comes up. There's just no two ways about it.
Yeah, for sure. They've sort of played with like AJ Styles isn't as much of a heel as he was recently. He's kind of been more face-ish.
So, I think Joe will cost AJ. Maybe Cena will win it clean because I think the Elimination Chamber pay per view is a SmackDown pay per view.
Oh, is it? Oh, actually.
And Joe may cost AJ there.
Ooh.
Joe will appear at least before WrestleMania, and that's
it's
what
his time.
I think that's what, because he's not in NXT anymore. It's quite clear.
Yeah.
He's not injured. He's done in NXT.
I think so.
So, whoever wins the Rumble, which belt are they going to go for?
Well, if Undertaker wins it, he'll pick his own, and he'll go for Cena.
Yeah, I think so.
So, how do you think it'll work? It'll be right, which wouldn't?
Yeah, because this week it was like...
Because Undertaker's cast is unassigned as well, so he isn't contracted.
Well, he said on Raw, didn't he? He said, I'll go where I want, and no one can control the Undertaker or whatever.
Oh, yeah, then he got in Steph's face, didn't he?
So, Undertaker will win, and he'll pick Cena.
Yeah, I think so. That makes sense.
Yeah, it won't even... I think Undertaker will be on Raw the night after Royal Rumble just to say that he's going to go for Cena and not go for the Raw title.
Yeah.
I think there's I'm not sure. I said this to you a few weeks ago when we were out that I actually think... I think we might get a surprise in the Rumble. Someone like Baron Corbin.
Ooh.
Because it looks like Corbin and Cena are going to be in a rivalry for a little bit.
Mm.
Just based Maybe. On based on what I saw on SmackDown.
Yeah,
I think there's legs in it.
Massive.
I think there's potential there for sure.
Because Cena's promo with Rene was pretty good as well.
Cena's awesome.
He's very good promo. Yeah.
Cena's really good,
and he really laid into Corbin. And I don't know if I'd like it if Corbin won the Royal Rumble. I think I'd prefer it and Undertaker won it. But
unless. Well, I mean, the other option is Corbin gets involved, costs Cena the belt, then they have like a little feud up until Elimination Chamber, maybe. Then Undertaker comes in, then they set up Cena versus Undertaker anyway. I have no doubt that's the route they're taking with this.
Yeah, it's got to be.
That's the only real match for Undertaker, I think.
I think so. It's going to be his last one. And then, it's got to be.
But I think he's going to... I just can't help but think Undertaker's going to win the belt.
Yeah.
I just think they're going to put it on him one more time and then he'll lose it.
Yeah, makes sense.
And then he'll lose it and retire, I should probably say.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be against it.
No, I wouldn't be against it either.
No,
I'd
be fine, yeah.
If he's there...
Yeah,
I don't want one of these half-assed champions who's not going to be there.
Well, like Brock when he was.
Brock when he was champion. Yeah, it's like he's going to be here once every 4 weeks. So what's the point?
Yeah, Paul Heyman. Paul Heyman will be here. We'll talk about it.
Paul Heyman will defend the title.
Yeah.
I mean, there's storylines in the Royal Rumble already. So Brock Goldberg is obviously going to be at WrestleMania. That's nailed on.
Yep.
Yeah.
I just think AJ won't WrestleMania. I just can't see it.
I mean, it'd be awesome if it did, but...
Of course.
Yeah, I think Undertaker Cena would be a bigger match than AJ versus whoever.
AJ versus whoever wins the Royal Rumble or whatever, I don't know.
Yeah.
Or whoever's going to challenge for the SmackDown title. It just doesn't seem right. It just doesn't seem right that AJ main events WrestleMania.
Yeah, as much as Smart like us like him, I'm sure his match would be amazing at WrestleMania, whoever he fights.
I think it doesn't seem right is probably the wrong way to put it. I think it just doesn't feel like he will.
Yeah, it definitely feels more like Undertaker seeing the thing, if that match is going
to
happen.
Which is it's the year to do it if they're going to do it.
For sure.
Yeah. But I just think it'll be, and if it's going to main event, it'll be for the title.
Yeah, I think so.
There's not another big enough feud to warrant main event in WrestleMania.
Yeah, agreed.
No, probably not.
No.
No.
There just isn't. I mean, no. As much as I would love to see Joe versus AJ tear it up in the main event of WrestleMania, yeah, it isn't going
it's
to
not
happen.
Gonna, yeah. No, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
Yeah.
No. Or maybe Joe enters into the Royal Rumble to come into the announce himself into the main roster. You know, Cena and AJ do whatever they do, then Joe confronts AJ on SmackDown. Well, it could happen anyway, but because Joe's done in NXT, I just can't see him not appearing before WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And if he's going to fight anybody, it feels perfect for him to fight AJ.
Yeah, I agree.
Cena, Undertaker, AJ, Samoa Joe. Reigns versus Owens, I'm going to say.
Yeah.
Or Reigns. No, Reigns versus Braun.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
For the Universal title.
That makes sense.
That's absolutely what's happening, I think.
Reigns versus Braun. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Reigns will win, but it'll make Braun look like a superstar.
I mean, Braun's sure. in the Royal Rumble.
He won't win it.
No, I don't think he'll win it.
I'm so convinced Undertaker's going to win it, I'm not willing to listen to any of the opinions.
With the Undertaker thing, I almost feel like, well, he's either coming back to win it, or he's coming back to set up the feud with Cena.
Yeah.
And you could have it either way. You could have the Undertaker Cena feud without him winning the Royal Rumble.
You could, yeah. But why be in the Royal Rumble?
Yeah. It's one of those. Yeah.
Goldberg and Brock, like, they're in the Royal Rumble to eliminate each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, which they will do. Yeah.
Of course they will. Yeah. Like, even if Goldberg eliminates Brock, Brock will come back and eliminate Goldberg, or vice versa, or whatever. But
yeah. Yeah.
Why be in the Royal Rumble if you're not going to win it, Undertaker?
He could just come back and main event WrestleMania, and no one would care if he won the Rumble or not.
Yeah.
So the fact he's going to be in the Rumble just kind of makes it so obvious that he's going to win it.
Really. Yeah, I mean, they always shoehorn a Taker match in at WrestleMania. Exactly, so yeah. So they didn't, yeah, like you say, they don't need the Royal Rumble as an excuse.
But I think he's ready to have him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I think he's ready for a run, and it just seems, if he's got this one final run in him, put the belt on him at WrestleMania, make up for him losing the streak and all that sort of stuff. So,
yeah.
So predicted WrestleMania card so far. Reigns versus Strowman for the Universal title.
Mm-hmm.
Owens versus Jericho.
Oh, yeah.
Owens versus Jericho. They'll have a fallout. Yeah.
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 Joe versus AJ.
Mm-hmm.
Cena versus Undertaker.
Yeah.
And
Seth versus
Triple H. Triple threat for the women's Raw title.
Bayley, Charlotte, Sasha.
Yep.
Yep.
Not
Fatal 4-Way.
With who, sorry?
Nia as well.
No.
It makes more sense with like 3 of the 4 women or whatever, I suppose. Yeah.
Same maybe for SmackDown. You could have Mickie James, Alexa, and Becky.
Yeah. Good work.
Yeah. Dean Ambrose will still be the IC champion at that point, I anticipate. So.
Could be.
Jeez, WrestleMania's going to be massive, isn't it?
Yeah.
It'll be huge. Yeah. We'll be sitting here at 5 in the morning again.
Yeah.
Fucking hell, is this still going on?
Oh, God.
AJ was brilliant, but this is a load of shit.
five in the morning, there's 3 matches left. Oh, my God.
Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah.
It's
WrestleMania is 8 hours long this year.
But I think that it'll be along those lines.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then you got the tag titles.
Cesaro and Sheamus. I think it'll be a multi-team tag team match. I don't think it'll be one-on-one.
Maybe, yeah. Then versus New Day.
Oh, Bray versus White. Bray versus White. Yeah, Bray versus White. He's new.
Oh, yeah.
Wyatt Orton. Bray versus Randy Orton.
Yeah.
So we're saying the Cruiserweight match will be on the pre-show.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Because the pre-show will probably be 3 hours long.
Yeah. Probably, yeah.
So there's a couple. They might even relegate Reigns to that.
yeah.
Universal Championship on the pre-show.
Yeah. It's a way off. I think we'll have a clearer picture in a couple of weeks after the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Yeah, you always tend to do it, don't you?
Because, I mean, Elimination Chamber will be throwaway.
Probably.
If it's a SmackDown pay-per-view as well.
Champion will come out.
Not that they're bad, but...
Yeah.
No, but it will be throwaway. Unless, AJ does win at the Royal Rumble, then Cena wins at Elimination Chamber, but I can't see it.
Yeah. maybe.
We'll see.
A lot of predictions.
A lot of predictions.
I've got a large book down there, please.
Oh, of course.
Not Batman, but the Batman. The WWE encyclopedia.
Oh, yeah, that's it. No, fumbling around. Okay. There we are.
I'm happy that you were strong enough to pick it up.
Yeah, there you go. Lifting weights.
Stevie gets picked. So, this week's episode of the Sonny and Finn Show is brought to you by the letter...
W?
Ooh.
W for wrestling.
For wrestling.
We've had a dick joke on there for a while. Let's go for Willie.
Willie Stroker? I've just made that up.
We had W once, actually, and we picked...
I said, because that's why I went W, because I wasn't sure.
Who was it like? Who did you pick W? Because we went, who?
Yeah, I think I did pick him, yeah.
Maybe.
Maybe kind
of. But why not? Let's go for it again.
Yeah.
Who? Tough to pick. Here's a shitty looking one. Waylon Mercy.
Yeah.
Height 6'7", weight 290 pounds, and his signature move was a sleeper hold. So we can already tell what kind of wrestler Waylon Mercy was.
Yes.
Technical wrestler.
Yeah.
A man of few words, but a variety of violent actions. Waylon Mercy came to WWE in 1995. He claimed to be a peaceful person and friend to all mankind. During his slow walk to the ring, he shook hands with fans, ring announcers, referees, and opponents alike, with an eerily calm demeanor. His interview sent chills down people's spines as he stated, "Lives are going to be in Waylon Mercy's hands." How long ago was it? It's 95. This one WWE was terrible. When the bell rang, Waylon became a man possessed and attacked opponents in a fit of rage. By October of that year, Waylon was forced to leave the ring after feeling the bone-crushing effect of Diesel's jackknife powerbomb. Waylon Mercy was not a man to be trusted, associated with, or challenged. He could snap at the slightest move or word and make people pay clearly for such offences. So what, he just left WWE after he got jackknifed by Diesel?
I guess so.
Diesel buried him.
Yeah.
Apparently so. That was like the time when WWE was very character based. So you still had Doink, and WCW was really starting to pick up. Yeah, WWE had Doink and Razor Ramon and Tatanka and other junk. Either way, this week's episode of the Sonny and Finn Show was brought to you by the letter W.
Yeah.
Waylon Mercy. Look at the picture there.
He's a handsome dude.
Yeah, yeah, I like his biro tattoos that he's got.
Yeah.
Yeah, what does that sound as well? Just turning the book upside down. Restitution.
Right.
No.
It's got a blood with it's got a knife with like some blood dripping off it.
No, very Shawn Michaels.
Yeah, it's got Mercy tattooed on his arm.
Oh, because of his surname. Yeah.
It's also got a downwards knife on his forehead as well. So.
Ah.
Later replaced by a penis, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Finn, now that I've seen you in glasses for the last hour or so, it's just like the norm now.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah.
Yeah, interesting.
So you're pulling it off.
Good.
Much like you did when you watched the VR porn.
Yeah.
Hey! Yes.
All 2 seconds of it.
Yes.
Good times. This is the Sonny and Finn Show. We are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts every single Friday across podcast services everywhere.
You
can go follow us on YouTube. Subscribe to us on YouTube, rather. YouTube.com/ Sonny Finn Play. You can also find Daydream the Gaming on YouTube. Also, we don't have an official URL yet, but
we'll get one.
Well, Finn keeps doing those Super Mario Maker streams. We'll be there in no time.
Yeah.
Go follow Steve on Twitter at SPW_85.
Yeah.
Follow the show on Twitter at Sonny Finn PC. Same on Instagram. You can also find us on Facebook. You can also find Daydream the Gaming on Facebook. Jesus Christ.
Anything else? Instagram?
Yeah, I said that.
You did? Okay.
Yeah. Don't worry, I've got it covered.
All right, cool.
Okay. Subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, rate us, and leave us a nice comment as well. Follow us on SoundCloud, or you can listen to us across any other podcast service you may use, including your Xbox One.
Yep.
But for now, thank you very much for listening. Steve, thank you very much for joining us again.
No problem. Anytime.
We'll be back very, very soon.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm Sonny.
I'm Finn.
I'm PODkins.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And if we've got time, we're going to go play Overcooked.
Cool.
So, goodbye, guys.
Thank you so much. Goodbye.
Bye. Bye.